Well, it's time to do a little work on my wife's 2006 Jeep Commander. Was doing a minor repair the other day. Replaced the right rear wheel sensor, speed sensor that went out. And I got to looking into there and realized we got a problem. So we'll go in there and show you what that problem is. And then we'll take on repairing the pinion seal on this 2006 Jeep Commander. So the other day when I was changing her right rear wheel speed sensor for ABS system, this is what I found. Bunches of goo and oil and goop everywhere up under the car. Hopefully you can see kind of up in there. Lots and lots and lots of oily stuff. And by all indication, it's sourcing itself from right here at the pinion seal. So we gotta replace this pinion seal. We're gonna do a bit more. We're gonna go ahead and change the differential fluid. It's not a requirement of changing the seal, but we know the fluid's potentially low anyway. It's a good time to go ahead and do it. We just gotta pull the pumpkin cover off the back. So we're gonna go ahead and pull the pumpkin cover, drain it, put the pumpkin cover back on, and then we're gonna come up here and we're gonna pull the drive shaft away here at the U-joint from the rear diff, and then access our pinion nut and go ahead and start taking this thing apart. So I'll show you more as we go. For now, that's what's going on. That's what we need to fix. Stop this thing. Rear diff on this thing bleeding to death. So here we go. All right, so we've got the diff cover off and we got it cleaned up the gasket surface here. All the way around, looking at the diff, the gears, everything, they look great. The there's no real oil. You'll just see a honey colored differential fluid, gear oil. So I'm happy, didn't expect to find any damage on the differential, but always worth a look. I wanted to go ahead and top off fluid, so I figured I'd change them. Anyway, makes me happy. I got the diff cover cleaned up. A little wire brush action there. And so it's good to go. So we're gonna get us some RTV gasket maker that we have here. And we're gonna put a bead all the way around the cover. And then we're gonna install it. It goes on, if you're curious. Basically it goes on like this. Fill holes about halfway up on the passenger side. Can't go on the other way because this gear needs this clearance on the back of the fan, so it's pretty evident pretty quickly. So it goes on like that. So we'll put some gasket maker on here, put this thing back together, and then we'll get started on that pinion seal. All right, well, we're gonna get on this differential seal now. Lest I fool you, this was easy. Let me correct. To remove these four bolts that hold the U-joint flange onto the pinion flange, and no, it wasn't easy. It took an impact, an impact socket, an extension, and a lot of finagling even to get around to that top bolt. These little wonders were very Loctited in place. Maybe you can see it's all covered in Loctite. And it wasn't red Loctite, it was blue, but it still wasn't easy to do. So we did manage though to get the bolts out, and so at this point I do have some little bungees. They're just little ones. I'm trying to catch the weight of the drive shaft there, but the expectation is we're gonna put a bigger bungee on there in a minute once we get this flange to come away. Not sure exactly what that's going to take just yet. Come on, big boy. Come away from there. Now, I didn't bring a hammer, so that's not going to happen. Now, I guess I better go get a hammer. See if I can get this thing to come away before I tear something up. I'm way too good at that. All right, so let's give this another try here. Let's see if I can bump the drive shaft backwards. Oh yeah, that opened up a gap. I don't beat the drive shaft to death. Just trying to bump it. Make a little space. There we go. Look at that. All right, so for now, those bungees are at least keeping us from getting smacked to the chin by that thing. Let's see if I can get my other bungee here. I can find it. And we're gonna try to hook this thing up a little more out of the way than that while we work on the seal. Yeah, come on. That's probably not a good place to hang it. Oh my goodness, where are we gonna put it? Got to be something up there worth hanging on to. Oh, there we go. Let's go around that thing. No, that ain't gonna work either. Oh, well, hopefully we'll go here. So we're doing this. My mom's out of town. My beautiful bride. So when she comes back, her car is all available to her. So there you go. It's up out of the way. Now we can get to this pinion. Fun stuff. Look at the size of that thing. So what we've got to do, we've got to do a few things here, just to be clear. First, let me clean this up a little bit, just so we can see better what's going on. Okay, and we did that for this reason. We're gonna have to count some threads to make sure that we get engagement. We're gonna have to make some marks to make sure we have alignment. So basically, we want to put this thing back in as much as possible, exactly the way it came out. So we're going to get our pick so we can count these. We got to get obviously a wrench, a socket, something big enough to wrap around that thing, and then we can remove it. The deal is, if you don't put this nut back in basically the exact same place it came from, you're changing the preload on your pinion gear. You don't want to change the preload on your pinion gear. Somebody took a lot of time in the factory setting your pinion gear preload, and so be sure you mark it and you return it to the exact position it came out of. Once this nut is off, we'll be able to remove this pinion flange. And once the pinion flange is off, we'll have full access to the seal. So, nut comes off, pinion flange comes off, and then pinion seal can come out. So, let's move on with it and get the right tools and get this job done. Alright, well, I've got a 30 millimeter wrench. Okay, I'm assuming this thing's metric for starters. Rest car is, I expect it is. I've got a 30 millimeter wrench and a 32 millimeter wrench. Sockets, nothing like that. So 30 millimeters too small, 32 is too big. So does that mean it's a 31 millimeter, or does that mean it's an inch and a quarter? I do have an inch and a quarter wrench and an inch and a quarter socket, half inch drive. So not exactly sure it's inch and a quarter, to be honest with you, but it's somewhere around there. It's either 31 millimeter or inch and a quarter. Inch and a quarter certainly fits, but you don't get much penetration around the nut with your wrench. So not too fond of that. I'd rather much rather use a socket. The only socket I have is 12 point. Which, if it's not a great fit, 12 points, not a great call. But at this point, I think that's what I'm going to do. What I'm going to have to deal with. It's an inch and a quarter, 12 point socket, and an impact. And if we can get this thing to come loose without tearing up the nut, then it's going to be a bad day. Anyway, let's see what we can do. Moving on. I'll let you watch. You can hear me cry if it doesn't go well. There we go. Come on, get in there. All right, fine. Yes, I know. This is not an impact socket. But it just happens to be the one I got. Okay. Brilliant me. I knew it was something I was forgetting to do. Which, it did move a little. Putting a black mark here. And one. Right here. On the nut. I was looking for my white paint marker. That little baby's non-existent. Also, let me say, I got this thing up on ramps. But do please chalk your vehicle before you take your drive shaft off. Front of this vehicle is chalked. Once you take the drive shaft off, she's a roller, so yeah, you don't want to be under a wheel. So let's try this thing. See what happens. I think it may come loose. Let's see. Oh yeah, I'd say she's gonna come loose. One thing I didn't tell you. Let me just put that back in there. Thing I didn't show you was that I had taken a pick, wonderful pick, and I'd come down center line. You pick your location, doesn't matter. And I counted back number of threads. In this case, it's just one thread, so I know if this mark and this marker lined up, and I've got one thread showing, then I'm back to the factory preload on the pinion gear. So one thread. All we need, and this mark and this mark aligned. So hopefully you can see those. Maybe you can't. 1¼ socket on impact. Looks like it's working. Like so. Yeah, didn't hurt it. Good. All right. Next thing's next. See if we can get this pinion gear out of here. I am not doing good under here. Make sure I'm glad I put this thing on ramps. I'm struggling today. I don't know why. Alright, we'll be back to you in just a minute. Alright, back at you. Sorry about that. So, next thing we need to do is pull the pinion flange. We get a screwdriver up in here. Yeah, there it comes. Now, it's probably not necessary. I'm going to mark my pinion flange relative to this same mark here. So that my pinion flange comes back in at the same place as well. Necessary? I don't know. If I was smart, I'd probably hire somebody to do this, so don't look at me for smart. Alright, so there's our pinion flanges off. And one thing I'm going to do, I told you those nuts were pretty difficult to get out of there because of the Loctite. Honestly, they look a little rough in the threads. I'm going to go ahead and, before we reassemble this thing, I'll take this pinion flange in the house, in the shop, and I'm going to go ahead and tap those out and clean these bolts up real good. Make this thing where it'll go back together real well. Make life a little simpler on the reinstall, because my guess right now is we're not going to get a seal today anyway, but we'll find out. So that thing, we'll do a little clean up, fix up on it and get it going. Now for the next thing. The actual seal. That's what we came here for, isn't it? So the seal, you can see the rubber seal there. It's much more than that. We need to figure out where the seal is, and I think I found the edge of it here. I want to clean this up a little anyway, because we drive our seal back in here. hopefully don't want to drive a bunch of goo back in here. So we'll get rid of the worst of this covering of goo. Excuse me. I want to sneeze so bad it's ridiculous. All right. So for now, we'll call that clean enough. We got the bulk of the goo off of there. Now we got to figure out how we're going to get this out of here. Generally speaking, my tendency would be to use a screwdriver along the edge and try to get under it. This thing looks pretty stuck in there. So we may end up having to use a slide hammer, a seal puller slide hammer, which I got. So let me go get a seal puller. And see if this thing is going to choose to cooperate or not. So let's see. Yeah, okay, so I tried that fancy slide hammer deal. And yeah, it's not working so great. So, brute force and ignorance, one of my better things. We're working around it. Managed to get under it with a chisel, working around it with a screwdriver. That's a never fail technique, pretty much. One thing I'm trying not to do is tear the seal up too much, because I've had trouble finding markings on this rune casting, and they list several options for this car, and darned if I know which one I need. So just gonna take it with me if I can keep from totally destroying it while getting it off. It is sneaking its way off here, so we're gonna make it, but how long it's gonna take, that's another matter. But we're getting there. Oh yeah, getting there good. Like somebody or factory used a sealant around the outside. I'll take that under advisement. There's a orange silicone RTV type sealant around the outside of the seal, so that might be something we need to duplicate. I don't think this thing was leaking from there, so I've got some black RTV that I used from the pumpkin, so I'll probably try it on here. Oh, look at that. Let's get this thing out of here. That might be part of why it's failed, but that's probably just from me trying to slide hammer it. The little spring was out of the back of the seal. Anyway, so we can take this down now and get a pretty decent match, because it's in reasonable condition. I think we will clean this RTV out of this hole, clean this up good, and then yeah, we'll probably RTV it when we put it back in. A little gasket maker never hurt anything. It also would tend to lubricate the reinstall. I don't think we terribly need to do a ton of cleanup on this thing. A little bit of extra RTV on this isn't going to change our world. Gasket sealer still going to form around it quite well. Get as much of the grease and oil out there as we can. The diff's not full anyway, so that's not a problem yet. So it shouldn't be running out once we get it clean. Yep, so let's see if we can find the right diff seal, pinion seal, and we'll go from there. I look to be doing okay here today. Not a bad day for Trey. Alright, so we got our seal. This one's slightly different in design. It's got a little lip here. It also has a sealer type material added to the edge, so we're not going to use RTV. But what happens though, whenever you press that pinion flange in there, it's going to compress this down, and so the seal's going to be very similar in design ultimately. So, time to put the pinion seal on. Other ways to skin this cat. We're going to do it the steady as you go method. Just tap this little monkey in there until it bottoms out against the riparian housing. And try not to tear up the rubber seal doing it. Hopefully that little sealing material around the edge is sufficient. Alright, we're in there pretty good. Use my fingernail as a gauge, and I can't get my fingernail under it. A little bit right up there, so let's good now. Yeah, still a little bit of space. All right, so seals in. Now it's pinion flange. Now I got a little bit of a problem. Cleaned up the pinion flange, which is a good idea, but I cleaned my mark off the pinion flange, so I don't know exactly where it goes now, and it'll go a lot of directions. So we're gonna have to, I guess, go back and review some video. Thank you for your usefulness, and see if we can get it at least close relative to these holes. So figured out. I'll get back with you. Alright, so I went back, reviewed some footage. I think we're pretty close here. I'm not sure if I got you in a good place or not. I got a lot of background light going on here. Anyway, so I got you best I can here. So I put this back on. The holes were lined out this way best I could tell. So now it's time to reinstall this pinion nut. Now, because of the design of the seal, it's going to have to go in a little ways, so we're going to go ahead and just use our impact on a light setting to put it in on its lowest setting. And I can see the seal curling as it should. So we just need to find now our black mark and get it to line up. Yeah, there it comes right there. Now we need to check and see with our pick. I don't have my pick, but I can see there's one thread. So if we align this mark up correctly, a little bit more to go there, then we will have our correct preload on the pinion. Again, this is the lightest setting on this impact, so not as bad as it sounds. Alright, there you go. So now the mark on the nut's lined up with the mark on the pinion shaft, and so we're good. This thing has curled the seal, which is what we wanted it to do, and the seal's properly installed in the housing. I think we're pretty good. I did tell you earlier that it was my intention to clean up the bolts and threaded holes here on the pinion flange. I did just that. Cleaned up the bolts, and I chased these threads because they were a little rugged. So I'm going to go ahead and prep one of these. We're using the blue Loctite to tighten this, or to treat these bolts. So we're gonna drop our bungee. And we're gonna bring our shaft, drive shaft down. Hopefully line up our pinion gear. Or our pinion flange, rather. Yeah, I think we're good. These bolts go in so much nicer now. They went in really poorly before. After I took them out, it was just roughness and whatnot. For now, I'm gonna just get all four of these started, go ahead and get them tightened up, and I won't bother you with too much more of this. This is not a big deal. Worst of it's done. So, let me get back with you in just a minute. We're gonna finish this up right here. It's back together. Bolts are tightened. Drive shafts obviously attached. So everything should be good. I think just gonna add some fluid to the rear differential, which is not a big deal. Just fill it through the fill hole till it hits the point of overflow and you're full enough. Put the cap back in it and we're rolling. So one thing I probably will do is go under here and maybe give this a little wash up. Not sure. Maybe get my power washer under here. Oh, that's gonna be a wreck, but what you gonna do, right? Anyway, so that's pretty much it. Be sure when you do this pinion, if you do a pinion seal, check your preload, mark your preload nut on the pinion gear, you know, that's pretty much the worst of it. Confined space, I guess, is actually the worst of it. If you want to do anything useful, buy yourself a car lift. I wish I had one. So, I hope it's helpful, and I hope you have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.